Italian investigators are in Egypt to look into the death of an Italian graduate student who disappeared from his home in Cairo. The 28-year-old was researching unions and had published articles critical of the Egyptian government. Paul Chaderjian now reports.
Mourners gathered in Rome over the weekend to pay their final respects to Giulio Regini. Italy's government calls his death a barbaric act, inhumane. They have promised those responsible will be caught and punished. The 28-year-old disappeared in Cairo on January 25th. That day marked the anniversary of the 2011 Egyptian Revolution. Regini's tortured, burned, electrocuted, and beaten body was found 10 days later.
We want to condemn what happened to Giulio. We are sure the Egyptian regime killed many people without a reason. We think that 40,000 students were killed by this regime, and Giulio could be one of them.
Hundreds of protesters gathered in Rome after Regini's funeral to demand answers. They carried signs that read "Truth and Justice for Giulio Regini." There's speculation he was killed by Egypt's security forces. It's an accusation the government continues to deny.
It is very annoying and frustrating to hear of accusations and rumors about the involvement of security agencies. The Egyptian security agencies are known for integrity and transparency.
And that's what the Italian government is hoping for, a transparent investigation into Regini's death. The Cambridge University student had published articles critical of the Sisi government. He was researching independent unions in Egypt.
Before, we used to say or joke that it was always very dangerous for Egyptians, very safe for foreigners, but actually this has switched big time. A lot of foreigners are subjected to the same intimidation. A lot of times they're intimidated for deportation or actually also being imprisoned, and now we see forced disappearances too, like what happened to Giulio.
Activists, foreign media, and Regini's friends hope this case will bring international attention to the plight of the hundreds of people who are abducted and disappear in Egypt. Paul Chaderjian, Al Jazeera.